What made you want to become a fighter?
I got into a lot of street fights in Hawaii. So kind of then that's when it kind of went into competing. One day we just got a call to go fight in this thing called Kicking It. I think my first kickboxing fight was Kingpin Pacho. Or Poncho, something like that. Kingpin Pacho. I don't even know, but we didn't even train. I think it was a couple of days, and then from then on, I fell in love with it. I think from the street fighting to getting in the ring, and then from then on, I started kickboxing.
Listen, you always catch one thinking they hard until I unload bullets, tear the side of his car. Catch me with pride about a ball. My niggas is hard and do shit you only seen in Oz. Bang till a death in the yard. Feel me, kill me, or respect the guard. I'm a professor, but my lectures are hard. My verse bring cash like ATM cards. So get your checkbooks ready, cause I'm ready to charge. I'm talking 10,000 for 16 bars that's starting. And double act when the kid name starts sparking. Spit flames from my awesome. The reason I don't battle, cause every time I do, I murder rappers too often. Still do it with style, the kids stay flossing. You try to outfloss him, you'll lay in the coffin. Nina on my waist, low eyes stroll by. Heat it in your faces, barrel long like shoelaces.
I said the feeling when your face screaming shatter. 24-7, bring it up, yelling louder. If you're a friend of one of them, you see them in the dance. If I need Brooklyn, come to York, damn tada. Feeling when your face screaming shatter. 24-7, bring it up, yelling louder. If you're a friend of one of them, you see them in the dance. If I need Brooklyn, come to York, damn tada.
Pressure is when you miss your kid from going to tour, doing a bit. When your baby mama's bugging on you, dissing your fam. But it's the only way you know to put some cheese in your hand. Cheese in your pocket, better than a burner to your socket or your face or your ribs. A legal life, no way to live shit. What you know about concrete pants? I was eating from the garbage, suicide in my head. And I robbed and I lied and I stole to survive. But then I got me a job on Wall Street, 9 to 5. It was the same old shit, daddy, but wearing a tie. I wish it was 6 feet deep, kissing the skies, kissing the dirt. Following gravel, head to the bow, rope to your neck. Time for the game, time for respect. Coming to York till I die, put it in you like sex. So don't get mad, cause I used to get more head than your neck. But then I slowed up the game and taught the kids on next. When I spit, it's like a cannibal on a bucket of text. I'ma shoot for the stars, never miss what I aim. But I can hustle out Monopoly, you ain't got no game.
Cause yeah. If you feel it when your face screaming shatter, 24-7, bring it up, yelling louder. If you're a friend of one of them, you see them in the dance. If I need Brooklyn, come to York, damn tada. Feel it when your face screaming shatter. 24-7, bring it up, yelling louder. If you a friend of one of them, you see them in the dance. If I need Brooklyn, come to York, damn tada.
To represent the state of Hawaii?
For me to represent the state of Hawaii means everything, actually. We, as people that grows up in Hawaii and Hawaiians, we take a lot of pride in our islands. And it's not only representing the whole island of Hawaii, like mainly representing the city of Nanakuri, where I was kind of formed into fighting and kind of mold to the person I am today. Mm-hmm. But representing Hawaii means everything to any Hawaii fighter that comes out of Hawaii. You know they're super prideful for where they came from.
Why did you move from Hawaii to Arizona?
My girlfriend's mom had a house out here, and I got to the point where we couldn't progress in Hawaii. Then we ended up moving here September 2011, and then, but I'm happy I moved here, but there's no beach. The closest thing to the beach is
Big Surf. That's about it.
How do you think living in Arizona has helped your training compared to being back in Hawaii?
I think it helped it tremendously. Back in Hawaii, we used to do things as we go. But here in Arizona, everything is about a book and they're strict, they're on you, and down to the dieting, strength and conditioning. So it helped, to me, it helped tremendously, you know. Arizona will play a big part in my success.
How has Power MMA helped you in your training?
They helped me huge. When I first went there, Tom Vaughn was a trainer. I didn't feel like I was welcome there when he was there. I still went because of the fact that Ryan Bader was there and a couple other guys and Kiko and sparring and stuff and other things too. But as soon as Aaron Simpson took over the program, it went from to a whole nother level to me like completely training there, and I felt good, and they helped me out a lot. They really do, from strength and conditioning to wrestling. That was my biggest downfall, was wrestling. Now I need to get into jiu-jitsu. They got a black belt trainer, Andre, to Muay Thai, to their boxing. So they helped me out a lot because they got the whole full arsenal of everything, and they got coaches for each discipline. So it makes it that much easier to learn and much better to learn. And to tell you the truth, the opportunities are endless with Power MMA.
Who beats you up the worst?
Who beats me up the worst? Probably like CB and Yeah, probably CB, because he his cardio is like, even when he's not training, his cardio is tremendous. And, you know, we can go around a few rounds together where I give him a run for his money, but after like two or three rounds, like, then he starts taking over. But yeah, CB, he's pretty strong and fast and relentless. Bader too, but Bader, I think he tried to controls too much. But CB, he doesn't really control, and he just pushed me to my limit, which is good. But I would say CB. But other than that, my lady.
Thank you.
Before going pro, you almost quit MMA. Could you talk more about that?
Yeah, before I went pro, I was competing at amateur, and it was so hard to get a pro fight here in Arizona. Than that. So I fought amateur a few times, I think two or three times, maybe four times here in the States, trying to get a pro fight, and then I couldn't. I was like, man, I wanted to quit because there was no sense of fighting for free. I had my daughter at that time too, so I was like contemplating on quitting MMA and just full-time work and just take care of my family. Months later after that, I got a message on Facebook from Kai Kamaka saying that they have a pro fight for me here in Arizona against Ashley Gooch, and man, from then on, it took off. It was a huge, huge blessing in disguise for me. Then it changed my mind to compete again, because at the amateur level, I felt like there was no competition here in Arizona. I just was beating people. And, you know, I mean, it was good. Of course, it was good. But it just was like, I needed, and also I needed to get paid, yeah. I had my daughter, stuff like that. But other than that, yeah, I really was going to just work full time and stop fighting.
Pussy that come with, so full of focus, I'm insisting on keeping it going.